Hey, what's up, guys? It's the Vegan Prince, Tim Shieff, and you're watching the Vegan Documentary.
It's all love, it's all love, all love. No dairy, no sweets, only ripe vegetables, fresh fruit and whole wheat. I'm from the old school, my household smell like soul food, bruh. Curry falafel, barbecue tofu, no fish though, no candy bars, no cigarettes. Only ganja, fresh squeezed juice from oranges. Exercising daily to stay healthy, and I rarely drink water out the tap cause it's filthy.
Lentil soup is mental fruit and ginger root is good for the youths. Fresh vegetable with them Italian stew. Sweet yam fries with the green callaloo. Careful how you season and prepare your foods, cause you don't wanna lose vitamins and minerals, and that's the jewel. Life brings life, it's valuable. So I eat what comes from the ground, it's natural. Let your food be your medicine.
Basically, you've got a few different types of diets, and I don't consider veganism as a diet. For me, it's a lifestyle. So the first thing you would have is pescatarianism. This is where you live as a vegetarian, but it is okay to eat fish. So they eat fish, dairy, eggs, honey, and vegetation. And you've got vegetarians who don't eat meat and fish, so they eat dairy, eggs, honey, vegetation. Veganism, on the other hand, as I said, is a lifestyle. So you don't eat anything that's from an animal. So you don't eat fish, meat, eggs, honey. I tend to stay away from palm, even though it's a plant. It's the biggest cause of deforestation in Malaysia and Indonesia. And the farmers are told to murder the orangutans on site. So certain things I try and stay away from. I try and stay away from soy as well, because it's grown in third world countries. So it's not necessarily about cutting out animal produce, but having the compassion of where it comes from and what kind of problems it can cause in the world. And me myself, I don't wear anything from an animal as well. So I don't wear leather, certainly not fur.
Being vegan in London is one of the easiest things I've ever had to do. I lived in London for 4 years now, and I've been vegan for 2.5. And becoming vegan, at first you feel like it's not convenient or you're not sure how you're going to do it. But it was a mindful decision I had to make. So I was going to do it regardless of whether it was easy or hard in London. But as I turned towards it, I discovered all these restaurants that I used to walk past every day that are vegan. I didn't realise around central London, even places like Nando's, Wagamama's, Las Iguanas, Jamie's Italian, they all have vegan options, vegan menus. You can go in there. Just even foods you used to eat before anyway, like hummus and peanut butter, it's vegan. It's not that complicated. And as long as you've got supermarkets, Sainsbury's, you've got Tesco Express, as much as I don't like to support them over, you know, the grocery stores and that, just these supermarkets, Tesco Express, Sainsbury's, Asda, they sell so many vegan options. They're all selling milk alternatives. They're all selling vegetarian sausages and everything. It's become the simplest thing, and it's amazing to see the growth of it. But at the same time, it already existed before that anyway.
Here, complain about not convenient, then I don't know, you know, it's really because they are spoiled, I think. Because nowhere else you can get like more convenient than this, I guess. Not many places. Maybe LA, maybe New York, but not anywhere else. Gets better than this.
I think that it's increasingly getting easier, especially in places like London, where you do have people from different cultures, different backgrounds. So yeah, you go to the markets, there's lots of markets, especially in East London, where you can get lots of nice healthy fruit and veg.
You have to make an effort to make nice food for yourself and to make sure that you get everything in your diet. But if you make the effort, it's the healthiest way of life that there is, really. I'm very athletic. I swim three times a week, sometimes for about an hour and a half. I've never haven't had any meat or fish for 25 years.
It's also sustainable for the environment. If more people focused on health and nutrition, you'd have a healthier society. If you have a healthy society, you have a much happier society, and therefore you cut down on a lot of public costs, like hospital costs go down. You no longer have that many sick people because they're all healthy. And it takes away the cultivation of animal products. So instead of having slaughterhouses where so many animals are, you know, being slaughtered just for their eggs, for example, you take that out, you have much more healthier foods. You can make your own milk, for example. We make our own milk. We make that with almonds. Simple procedure, just soak it, blend it, and squeeze it in the nut bag, and you've got milk.
I feel that there is a stereotypical background. I mean, I know years ago that, you know, if you see a so-called vegan, they're very skinny, lethargic, pale, no energy, you know, just... And I think that's become like the basis of all vegans. You know, if you look at the vegans now, like, you just do a search, quick search on Google, top 10 vegan athletes, and a whole list of athletes will come up, NFL, football, you know, American football players, you know, people doing parkour, you know, long distance runners, sprinters, they're all becoming vegan because they're finding it the best way to be. And I think we all get trapped in inside society where if they're all doing it, then it must be right. You know, and it's not necessarily the case. And if you can break free and just let go of any kind of thought of, no, that's right, no, that's wrong, you know, and just be open-minded and have a look of what it actually is, yeah, then you're going to see the real truth in things, whether it's right or wrong, in anything.
Ventures buffet, you have to try it. It's super cheap. It's $5.50 for a box. You can pile it up, whatever you want. It's like 30 something dishes, right?
Yeah, they have raw options. They have the good thing about Ventra is that they don't fry food or do the Asian dishes in the traditional way. They steam food.
But I use an app on my phone called Happy Cow, happycow.net, and it's a wonderful site worldwide that has vegetarian and vegan friendly restaurants and stores all over the world. And when I travel, I use that, so it's the first thing I do when I get to town is find out where all the vegan places are, raw food restaurants, and it makes it a lot easier. And so there's a plethora of options in the city of London, especially if you have a resource like that to look back to, or like in this case the workshop, doing meetup groups, and you know, you can find other people and network with vegan potlucks, vegetarian potlucks, things like that too.
There's, I think it's called Tao in Piccadilly Circus, and they do Asian food very, very good. There's another Asian one called the Loving Huts in that second archway. And then you've got like a cafe. It's more vegetarian, but they do vegan as well. It's called Beetroot, and that's just off Oxford Street.
Dead animal body, up in my body. Live life, we don't eat death. Look at my dinner plate, there's no dead animal flesh. Nah, I don't care if you used to walk, cross, swim or fly. I ain't eating it if I had a head. No poultry, no red, no milk, no cheese and no egg. In the summer I'm blessed cause I'm over the farm meditating under the sun. Vegetarian blood, don't invite me to your barbecue because I won't come. Don't eat dead animals, living animals know this.
The first one we have here is a raw kale cheesecake. It has not been baked at all, so by not baking it and by not heating it up, you're not losing any nutrition whatsoever. So it's packed with all the nutrition you need, really beneficial for you. It's got a crunchy almond base. So there's almonds, dates, coconuts, And then there's a cashew mousse with a little bit of banana, kale, coconut oil, coconut flakes, and hemp seeds on top. The raw brownies over here are similar. We've used nuts once again. This time it's walnuts and almonds, coconut flakes, coconut oil once again, and a cacao glazing. Now, in the cacao glazing, instead of adding water to it to turn it into chocolate, we've used fresh orange juice, and we've also added fresh orange zest. So we've grated the skin of the orange and put that in there as well. So once again, both are packed with nutrition, gives your immune system all the nutrition it needs to fight away any ailments, etc. We also do dehydrated wraps, which are these ones here. And these are dehydrated. So by dehydrating, we mean that we are extracting the moisture out. So it's a similar concept as you have drying foods in the sun. Many years ago, that's how people got through the winter. They'll get their foods, dry them in the sun, and they'll preserve, and they could go through the winter. What we've done is the same thing, whereby we've preserved the nutrition once again. So a lot of emphasis on nutrition, which helps with health. And inside of those, we put the raw pumpkin seeds, hummus, we put red peppers and fresh vegetables, etc. But that's general ideas, nutrition really.
But there are a lot of healthy snacks coming out now, which are really delicious, but a little bit pricey. But I think there will be more and more really. And people should really try to make some snacks themselves. It's just fun.
Don't eat dead animals, the living animals know this. They love me, close to nature. Like Mowgli, when I'm in the park, the animals spot me. Vegetarian blood, I'm a vegetarian blood, blood. Vegetarian blood, I'm a vegetarian blood. I'm a vegetarian blood, I'm a vegetarian blood, blood. Vegetarian blood, I'm a vegetarian blood, blood. Yo, boy, better know I eat dates and grapes. Don't eat kebabs cause they taste nasty. I won't say nothing, let a man with a chip might walk straight past me. I don't wanna be depressed and angry.
I think they're looking good.
So today I'm gonna cook vegan blueberry pancakes. You might wonder, how the hell is he making pancakes without using eggs, milk, and all these kind of like animal ingredients? Guess what? I found a recipe on the website, and today I'm gonna make it.
Vegetarian blood, I'm a vegetarian blood. I'm a vegetarian blood, I'm a vegetarian blood, blood. Vegetarian blood, I'm a vegetarian blood, blood. Yo, you need electric food, got energy, I'm the electric dude. The brain runs on electrical impulses, don't believe me, check it out, it's true. Eat too much meat, drink too much alcohol. Eat too much cheese, drink too much milk, eat too many eggs. That's why your battery's dead. The biggest killer on the planet is disease. The only reason why we're victim, because of what we eat. I call it eating death, they call it a treat. I'm submarine, need no TV and no processed meat. No, I'm not one of them sheep. Them humans can't even hear my words.
Veganism, the truth of veganism is in the experience of it. You can't know something's right or wrong until you've experienced both. With sex, if someone was to try and tell you about sex is good or bad or give you advice and they were a virgin, you're not going to listen to it. You wouldn't take their advice. Whereas if someone's tried vegan and was not vegan, I was not vegan for 23 years of my life. Then I became vegan and I go, wow, what the hell was I doing there? Why didn't someone tell me sooner? This is life-changing stuff. It's phenomenal what it can do. Like, actually, it's beautiful. It's a miracle to me when I discovered this, how it changed my life. I've experienced both sides of the counter now. I know what both sides are like. And this one is so much prettier, more beautiful and sexier than the other one. And it may just, as I said, benefits everything around you. You know, if you want to be healthy, you want to be happy, try something new and you never know what you'll learn.
I enjoy doing it. I enjoy traveling. I enjoy sharing what I do with others. So I think it, for now, will be part of my travels wherever I go, just because there's a need and a desire to have some, in this case, sweets, you know, that are vegan, vegetarian, gluten-free alternatives. And it seems to be something, a hit. People really enjoy it. It's a lot of fun. So I think I'll keep doing it for years to come.
Mentally, I was missing all the ice cream and cakes and pizza and stuff that I could have before. But then soon I discovered that I could have them. still, because there's vegan version of vegan cakes and vegan ice cream. And just like when I turned vegetarian, I thought I was going to miss out on everything, but then I discovered that there's vegetarian things that you can have same as before. So it's all about new discoveries, and when you make the journey, you discover new things. You don't miss out anything.
Then let's talk about the liquor and the alcohol and the guns. The chicken got you wanting to use the gun because it's not real chicken. It's not real carrots. And the carrots are fake anyway, and they're making fake, real fake foods. This stuff is getting crazy.
Vegetarian blood, I'm a vegetarian blood, blood. Vegetarian blood, I'm a vegetarian blood. I'm a vegetarian blood, I'm a vegetarian blood, blood. Vegetarian blood, I'm a vegetarian blood, blood. Yo! Vegetarian blood, I'm a vegetarian blood, blood. Vegetarian blood, I'm a vegetarian blood. I'm a.
Mmm.